Highness Princess Ghida Talal, Royal Highness Princess Raja Talal, President Ajoya, Your Excellency Sheikh Mayasa bin Hamad Al Thani, Your Excellency Abdullah bin Hamad Al Atiyah, Your Excellency Sheikh Abdurrahman bin Saud Al Thani, Ambassadors, Excellencies, members of the faculty, ladies and gentlemen, members of the class of 2015. Welcome to the commencement exercises of Georgetown University's School of Foreign Service in Qatar. Please remain standing for the national anthems of the State of Qatar and the United States of America. Please be seated. It is our custom to begin and end our ceremonies with prayer. At the beginning, we invoke God's presence to come with his grace and heavenly aid to fill the hearts which he has made, as the hymn has it. And at the end, we ask for God's blessing. Salar Mujib Khan, class of 2015, will offer the opening prayer, or what we call the invocation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين صدق الله العظيم.
Although the university's founding date is 1789, it was almost exactly 200 years ago, on the 1st of March, 1815, that the President of the United States, James Madison, approved the federal charter for, quote, the College of Georgetown within the District of Columbia, unquote, introduced into Congress by our first student, William Gaston. This spring, on March the 1st, 2015, the President of the United States, Barack Obama, sent greetings to Georgetown on the occasion of the bicentennial of that charter. Among other things, he said, and I quote, simply put, this country and this world benefit from your commitment to Jesuit values, to being men and women for others, unquote. It is our venerable custom to begin our ceremonies, our academic ceremonies, with a reading of that charter. To this chartered office, I have the honor to present Mr. Edward M. Quinn, Secretary of the University.
An act concerning the College of Georgetown within the District of Columbia. Be it enacted by the Senate and House of Representatives of the United States of America in Congress assembled, that it shall and may be lawful for such persons as now are, or from time to time may be, the President and Directors of the College of Georgetown within the District of Columbia to admit any of the students belonging to said college or other persons meriting academical honors to any degree in the faculties, arts, sciences, and liberal professions to which persons are usually admitted in other colleges or universities of the United States, and to issue in an appropriate form the diplomas or certificates which may be requisite to testify to the admission to such degree. Signed, Langdon Chivas, Speaker of the House of Representatives, John Guyard, President pro tempore of the Senate, approved March 1st, 1815, James Madison.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct honor to invite Her Royal Highness Princess Ghida Talal of Jordan to deliver the commencement address. Royal Highness, let me briefly introduce you, although perhaps you have no introduction. Her Royal Highness is a Hoya. She is a graduate of the class, SFS class of 1986, and indeed also the MSFS, the Masters in Foreign Service. She's a chairperson of the King Hussein Cancer Foundation in Jordan. Hailing from a prominent family in Lebanon, she took the challenging 5-year, 1-in-2 combination of the BSFS and MSFS, which only the very best students attempt, and in parenthesis, we've had several of our Doha students accepted too, I'm pleased to say. It is also Georgetown that she first met her future husband. And after graduating, Princess Ghida pursued a career in journalism in London. Following her marriage in 1991 to His Royal Highness Prince Talal bin Muhammad of Jordan, the late King Hussein asked her to establish the International Press Office of the Royal Hashemite Court and to become his press secretary. In 2001, His Majesty King Abdullah II appointed her as chairperson of the King Hussein Cancer Foundation. Indeed, as the wife of a cancer survivor, Princess Ghida has devoted herself to the fight against cancer and has been a tireless fundraiser for the center. Princess Ghida has served on the Georgetown University Board of Regents and currently serves on the advisory board of the MSFS, the Master in Foreign Service. She's also on the board of the Scholar Rescue Fund of the Institute of International Education, and there she played a role in launching the Iraq Scholar Rescue Project, helping to bring Iraqi scholars back in touch with their academic networks and careers. Princess Ghida is also an active member of the Clinton Global Initiative and an honorary member of the Mediterranean Task Force for Cancer Control. She is honorary chairperson of the Jordan Society for Pediatric Oncology. And she's also a board member of the Jordanian National Gallery and, not least, the honorary chairperson of the Jordanian Swimming Federation. And today, she's your commencement speaker. Your Royal Highness.
Thank you. Sheikh Hamayasa, Your Excellencies, President Dedoya, Dean Noneman, proud parents, and my fellow Hoyas. I would like to start by extending my deepest and most heartfelt congratulations to everyone present for Georgetown Qatar's 10th anniversary, and to applaud the tremendous achievements that have taken place over this amazing decade. I am particularly happy that with us today is the one person who loves Georgetown more than I do. We shared the same dorm on campus, New South, and he was my wonderful RA. Many years later, his continued passion for Georgetown propelled him to become its star president, and I personally hope that he will stay in this position forever. He is, of course, President Jack Dedoya. SFS Qatar is only one beautiful example amongst countless others, and they are a direct result of the far-sighted leadership, of the far-sighted policies of Qatar's visionary leadership. His Highness Sheikh Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thani, Her Highness Sheikh Moza bint Nasser, and His Highness Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad have transformed a small desert peninsula in the Arabian Gulf into a household name like no other in every corner of the globe. Specifically, Qatar has successfully invested in establishing world-class institutions in diverse fields, such as education, Georgetown, healthcare, international centers such as Sidra, media, Al Jazeera, the world's news source, culture, both Islamic and Western, Sheikh Mayasa, culture, travel, Qatar Airways, arguably the best airline in the world, and sports, bringing the World Cup to the Arab world for the very first time. My fellow Hoyas, I cannot tell you how thrilled I am to be back amongst my School of Foreign Service family. Georgetown and SFS have played huge roles in my life. When I joined Georgetown, my country, Lebanon, was at war. Fear and chaos reigned supreme. My parents, my source of strength and guidance to this day, did not hesitate for a second and sent me to Georgetown. Georgetown, was actually the only university I applied to. For me, it was either Georgetown or nothing. Lucky for me, I got accepted. My parents ended up sending not just one, not two, not three, but four children to Georgetown. And in 3 years' time, my own children will hopefully continue this beautiful tradition and become Hoyas themselves, having been thoroughly brainwashed by their parents since they were in diapers. My daughter Raja is here with me for her first Georgetown experience. I must confess that it feels as though a blink of an eye has passed since I sat at my own SFS commencement 5 years ago. And now I find myself standing at the podium addressing new graduates. It is truly a surreal experience. So knowing firsthand what it is to sit in an SFS commencement audience, I was more than a little daunted when searching for remarks that could both engage young minds of your caliber and leave you with a few thoughts that you may find helpful as you embark on your journey through life. The obvious place to begin with must be our common point of departure, Georgetown. Our Georgetown education and the myriad tools that it has equipped us with, both intellectual and moral, to meet life's never-ending challenges and demands. More specifically, I refer to the School of Foreign Service, which has trained us in the subtle and sometimes not so subtle complex arts of international diplomacy. For many, the application of these arts is embodied in the words of the 19th century British statesman Lord Palmerston, who observed that nations have no permanent friends, only permanent interests. While there may be much truth to these words, my own experiences have shown me that Lord Palmerston was perhaps only telling us half the story. My life's experiences has taught me rather that in life, there are no permanent enemies, and that it is always in one's permanent interests to never stop trying to convert the adversaries of today into the staunch allies of tomorrow. I would point to the example of our prophet, who forgave his bitterest opponents and cruelest persecutors, turning them into champions of the faith, and thus bringing Islam to the ends of the earth in the space of a couple of generations. In my own personal life, I have the shining example of Jordan's beloved late King Hussein, who time and again transformed his would-be killers into the most die-hard of loyalists. This is why I believe that we have now moved well beyond Lord Palmerston's one-dimensional worldview. Instead, I urge you to never miss an opportunity to make a new friend and to nurture that friendship to its fullest potential. Never give up on those who have disappointed you in the past and extend instead the hand of reconciliation towards them. And finally, whatever you do, let it always be a labor of joy. In my life, Georgetown has been the foundation, the springboard that has enabled me to reach where I am today. So let me tell you where Georgetown propelled me. Immediately after graduation, I embarked on a career in journalism. I started with ABC News in London as a desk editor. The smart title of desk editor was actually quite deceiving. Armed with a bachelor's and master's degree, magna cum laude from Georgetown, I expected to find the world lying at my feet. I found myself right back at the bottom of the food chain. I had to start at the very bottom. I spent months working from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m., standing on my feet all day long, mechanically slicing off rolls of news feed for the journalists, bringing them coffee and biscuits, and never, ever being allowed to give my opinion, as if I were illiterate. But I learned immensely from that job. I could have done this job without any degree at all, but I persevered, hoping for better days. I realized that I had to prove myself in an area that was far from the Middle Eastern scene. So I had taken Spanish at Georgetown, and I spoke it fluently. So I grabbed an opportunity that presented itself to live and work in Argentina and cover Latin American news for the Sunday Times of London. Argentina, not the most normal course for a Middle Eastern woman. These few months in Argentina were, in retrospect, some of the best in my life. I covered the bloodless coup that toppled Latin America's longest living dictator, Alfredo Stroessner, and was exposed to an entirely new and beautiful world. A year later, when I married Prince Talal of Jordan, also an SFS Hoya, the head of my new family, His Majesty King Hussein, always used to tell us that HRH was only a title. He said that it was our character traits and our values that bestowed the title upon us. In turn, this is what I tell my children day in, day out. And those wise words have motivated me ever since. I am saying this to you graduates to show you that in life, you need to earn things and to keep striving to be the best version of yourselves that you possibly can. Nothing is a given, nothing stays the same, and the only thing you can expect is that unexpected challenges will always come your way. Shortly after my marriage, I wanted to pursue a career in journalism. King Hussein backed me and asked me to establish the International Press Office of the Royal Hashemite Court and to be his press secretary. Everything was wonderful. However, life had plans of its own. I was barely back from my honeymoon and still a carefree bride when my world was turned upside down. My husband was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma at the age of 26. In an instant, I fell head down into the world of cancer, of fear, of living in permanent anxiety. My husband's life was hanging by thread, and there was really only one choice ahead for me: fight, fight, and fight all the way. And this is what we did. A veil had been removed from before my eyes, and my priorities were readjusted in an instant. This experience led me to my true calling, my true passion, the fight against cancer. I have been leading this fight for 14 years now as chairperson of the King Hussein Cancer Foundation and Center. On a daily basis, the center that bears our beloved King Hussein's name is leading the battle against cancer in our region and is the only internationally accredited, comprehensive, standalone cancer center that is providing life-saving care to thousands of patients from all over the Middle East. Why am I telling you this? Of course, because it means a lot to me, but also because it was Georgetown that enabled me to cope with whatever life threw my way. It encouraged me to get out of my comfort zone and to take risks. Without Georgetown, I would have never had these skills. I would have probably remained very happily stuck in my comfort zone. Georgetown also gave me the education, the direction, and the strength of character to face my challenges head on, and not only overcome them, but transform them into some of my greatest achievements. In conclusion, I would like to leave you with my top 10 list, made up of pieces of advice that I wish I had been given at my own graduation. Number 10, measure a person by the size of their heart and not their bank account. Number 9, life is not fair. Just keep moving forward. Number 8, you will likely fail often. Don't let that discourage you. It's part of life. Number 7, if it doesn't feel right to you, don't do it. Walk away from it. Number 6, leave your comfort zone behind. Push the envelope. Move into uncharted territory. Number 5, do one thing at a time. Give all your attention to one assignment. Number 4, stay true to yourself and follow your passion wherever it takes you. Number 3, perseverance, perseverance, perseverance. Never ever give up. Number 2 comes from my all-time hero, the late Steve Jobs. He said, "Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. And most important, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition." And my prized number 1 comes in the rightful words of Michael J. Fox. Family is not an important thing. It is everything. My family is everything to me and has made me who I am today. Please take care of yours. You now belong to that unique and exclusive club, that of being a Georgetown graduate. I cannot think of a more exceptional badge of honor. You have earned it. To each and every one of you, and to your parents, Elf Mabruk.
Thank you, Your Royal Highness, for those inspiring, wise words. We now come to the conferral of degrees. Dr. Daniel Stoll, Associate Dean and Senior Advisor to the Dean, will call the names of the degree candidates. Where candidates have achieved so-called Latin honors from cum laude, which means with distinction, or praise, up to summa cum laude, meaning with the highest distinction or the highest praise, this will be noted after their name. Similarly, those inducted into a number of national honor societies in recognition of their excellence will have that society mentioned after their name. You will recognize these societies as three Greek letters. Each candidate will come forward to be hooded, to receive the diploma, and to be congratulated. After all the candidates have crossed the stage, Dr. James Reardon Anderson, Acting Dean of the School of Foreign Service, will present the candidates to the President, who will confer the degree in course. Dean Stoll.
Fatma Abdul Hamid Marafi, summa cum laude, Alpha Sigma Nu, Phi Beta Kappa. Ali Hassan. Sarah Ibrahim El Ahmed. Nasser Abdullah El Atiya. Ali Abdullah El Buainain. Maram Badr El Dafa. Khawla Abdullah El Darbasti. El Maha Ali El Hamadi. Mohammed Badr El Hanai, cum laude. Mohammed Majid El Khawari, cum laude. Jawahar El Mal, magna cum laude. Michelle Yusuf El Melki. El Jahra Abdullah El Manna. Nora Abdul Mohsen El Manna. Hessa Abdullah Nasser El Mesned. Talal Abdulaziz El Nama, cum laude. Jenna El Okar. Haya Saad El Ramehi. Moza Jassim El Suwedi. Aisha Hassan Athani. Mariam Mohammed Athani, magna cum laude. Noor bin Khanam bin Ali Al Thani, cum laude. Sheikh Ahmed Al Thani. Evin Belatbat. Mariam Bengali. Anya DeBach. Natalie DeYoung. Noor El Baroudi. Asma Mohammed Fikri. Nada Samir Habayeb. Omar Abdelkader Hashem. Sammy Farid Hassan. Fatima Mohammed Hubel, cum laude. Reem Jaudi, magna cum laude, Alpha Sigma Nu, Phi Beta Kappa. Sabah Khadri. Salar Mujib Khan. Mariam Dawish Lashin. Jung Hyun Lee. Kevin Mark Lee, magna cum laude, Alpha Sigma Nu, Phi Beta Kappa. Thoraya Samawa Lutfi. Mattia Malakanovich. Farah Imad Malah, summa cum laude, Phi Beta Kappa. Omar Daniel Masur. Atul Menon, Magna Cum Laude, Alpha Sigma Nu. Lina Nede Mohammed, Magna Cum Laude. Matthias Norfeld. Sarah Omar. Dana Karut, Magna Cum Laude. Andrea Quevedo Acuna, Magna Cum Laude. Badaruddin Jahad Rahima. Mark Selimovic. Bilal Shakir Cum Laude. Mohammed Abbas Sarah Khatim. Saif Mahmoud Talat. Sophia Vogel. Dimma Wihba. Harun Yassin.
You get the sense they're kind of popular, all of them. With us too. It is now my honor to present Dean James Redden Anderson of the School of Foreign Service, who will formally present the candidates to Dr. John J. DeGioia, the 48th president of Georgetown University, who will confer the degrees.
Candidates will please stand. President DeGioia, I have the honor to present to you these candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science in Foreign Service. These students have been duly examined and recommended by the faculty and approved by the Board of Directors. I therefore ask that you bestow on them the degree and course.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Congress of the United States and by the Board of Directors of Georgetown University, I officially confer upon these candidates the degree of Bachelor of Science in Foreign Service. Congratulations.
Members of the class of 2015, you richly deserve the congratulations you have just received. You have all worked hard and achieved much during your years at Georgetown. None of you, however, has managed to do this on your own. You have benefited from the knowledge and wisdom of your professors, and you have been supported by families and friends. So now it is time, graduates, to turn around and applaud the people who helped you to get to this day.
President DeGioia will now offer some closing reflections. President DeGioia.
That's okay. Well, thank you very much, Dean Nahneman, for your leadership here in our campus in Doha. And I wish to begin by expressing our deepest gratitude to Her Highness Sheikha Moza and the Qatar Foundation for their extraordinary vision and generosity, which have enabled our work here in Education City. Thank you to Her Royal Highness, Princess Ghida Talal, for making this very special day that much more special by sharing with us your perspective and insight that you've gained through your life's work and your journey since your commencement from the School of Foreign Service not that long ago. We're honored by the presence of our special guests, Her Royal Highness Princess Raja Talal, Her Excellency Sheikha Al-Mayasa bin Hamad Al-Thani, His Excellency Abdullah bin Hamad Al-Attiyah, the ambassadors, welcome all of you. And I wish to express my appreciation to Dean James Reardon Anderson for his dedication in leading our School of Foreign Service at Georgetown University. Jim. Thank you. Well, it is my great pleasure and privilege to be here with you all today, to share in this moment, this celebration with you, our graduates of the class of 2015, with your families, with this Georgetown community here in Qatar. A word of gratitude to your families for the trust that you have placed in us, for your education, for your formation as young women and men ready for the responsibilities of global citizenship and your chosen professional and academic careers. Thank you also to the extraordinary faculty who are seated behind me for the deep care and commitment that you invest every semester in teaching, in your scholarship, and the way in which you enhance the academic vibrancy of this university community. And to our staff, I want to thank you all for the extraordinary contributions that have made today possible. And finally, to our graduates, to the women and men before me, congratulations. It's a privilege to share this special day with you. This is a very special moment in your lives. It's a moment of beginning, of commencing, of looking toward the future, to the great journey that lies before you, to the challenges that you will encounter, the trials you will endure, the victories that you will claim, the unique impact that you will make. It is my sincere hope that this university, your university, which you will always call home, that the friendships that you have forged here, the knowledge that you have earned here, will provide you with the resources for each of the steps ahead. This is a moment grounded in all of your hard work leading up to today, and in the journey of exploration that you have taken throughout your time at Georgetown, expanding your minds and your hearts to meet the needs of our world. You have engaged in the work of formation of your intellect and of your character, the development of the framework through which you will engage the world. This is the work through which we seek to understand ourselves, our own humanity at ever deeper levels. This is the quest for self-knowledge. And you've engaged in this work at an unprecedented moment in history, particularly in this region. Most of you arrived here on our campus in the fall of 2011. In the months preceding your arrival, from the early unrest in Tunisia to the protests in Egypt and Yemen, spreading to Bahrain and Libya and Syria, through the spring and summer, the Arab Spring created a tectonic shift. In Syria, we see a convergence of forces, from the efforts to usher in regime change to the displacement of millions of refugees to Lebanon, Turkey, and Jordan, to the new front against the Islamic State. More immediately, especially in recent days, we witness events unfolding in Yemen. You have seen regime change, in some cases violent and others orderly. Here in Doha, for almost two decades, Sheikh Hamad bin Khalifa Al Thani led Qatar, transforming this nation and its role on the global stage. And in the 2 years since succeeding his father, Sheikh Tamim bin Hamad Al Thani, one of the youngest heads of state in our world, has provided steady leadership. We had the honor of hosting the Emir on our campus in Washington this past February. Further change is coming, and no 4 years have seen so much change in this region. This is the world in which you were educated, in which you engaged in the work of formation. This is the world you will be entering now as global citizens. This is the world in which you are prepared to lead, and we need you. Recently, I've been reminded of a statement by one of the great policymakers of the last half century. John Gardner was one of the architects of a set of programs called the Great Society, which sought to address some of the deepest problems in 1960s America: poverty and racial injustice. And when talking about the challenges of this type of work, the paradox of taking on such formidable tasks, he noted, quote, "What we have before us are some breathtaking opportunities disguised as insoluble problems," close quote. Breathtaking opportunities disguised as insoluble problems. This reminds us that the hope for our societies is a matter of imagination. It is a hope built upon a persistence to always relentlessly seek answers, find solutions, to strive for the betterment of our communities, our nations, our societies. When we take as our starting premise that breathtaking opportunities are within our grasp, that seemingly insoluble problems can be surmounted, it changes everything. It brings us a new lens to questions like how we can better care for one another, how we can build our societies so that they are more inclusive, how we can together better address the challenges that confront us, from global warming to pandemics to the enduring legacies of inequality, injustice, and violence around our globe. Looking at all of you, I am confident that you, our graduates, of whom we are extremely proud, have the skills, the depth of thought, fullness of heart, the imagination to seek the betterment of humankind. You came to Georgetown with an eagerness to engage ideas and cultivate your intellect, to forge your conscience and deepen your character. Now, as you graduate, you embark on another very special time in your lives. This is your time. We could not be prouder. We could not be more honored to share this moment with you. Congratulations to you all. It's a privilege to be with you.
Thank you, Dr. DeGioia. Please stand and join the class of 2015 in the singing of the Alma Mater. You'll find the words and music on the last page of the program, which, given the bilingual structure of the program, means right in the middle of the booklet. Following the singing of the Alma Mater, please remain then standing for the benediction, which will be offered by the Reverend Thomas Michel of the Society of Jesus, visiting professor at Georgetown University, SFS Qatar.
Today, we ask God to bless our graduates in many ways. We pray that they may find happiness in their personal lives and be successful in their career endeavors. May their lives always be guided by high ideals of compassion and justice. May God always protect them from all harm. May they be sensitive to the needs of others, and may they always carry with them a sense of service, a willingness to serve their nation, their people, and their loved ones. May they never forget the God who accompanies them every day in their lives. And may God also bless the families of our graduates. Their sacrifices have, in so many cases, made it possible for our graduates to reach this day. And so we ask God to grant them their just reward. Finally, on this day in which we all feel so much pride in the achievement of our graduating class, may God shed many blessings on the faculty and staff of Georgetown University and bless our institution for years to come. Amen.
Please remain standing at your places until the platform party and the students have recessed. All are then cordially invited to join Georgetown's newest graduates at a reception in the library, which is behind us. The 2015 commencement exercises of Georgetown University School of Foreign Service in Qatar are now officially closed. May Georgetown live forever.